Hello to all mass-inclined people. Today is a nice day and we are in a lovely place, really nice place, Pembroke College in Cambridge. That's why today I want to talk about really nice mathematical effects. Let us begin with this nice pie.
Let's take a look at the crown of the spine, more specifically at the contour of its top. We will highlight it with a bold yellow line. Then let's zoom in. You've noticed that the yellow line doesn't match precisely the real contour, and we see some gaps. Let's zoom in again and look more carefully at the contour. We've made it thinner for more clarity. If we drew the contour line again, we would see this purple line. Let's compare these two lines on a separate slide. If we look closely, it's clear that the purple line delineates the contour more precisely. Notice that one yellow interval of convexity corresponds to several purple intervals of convexity and concavity. I think you would agree that the purple line is not ideal and is precise only at this zoom level. If you zoom in to see an individual branch, the purple line will be a very coarse approximation. A new contour line will become a coarse approximation if we zoom in to see individual needles. In math, sometimes you can zoom in and refine the contour line infinitely, although in real life it's not quite true. But we are not going to consider physics right now. Let's consider some curves that could be represented as graphs of functions on the Cartesian plane. When we consider simple classes and deal with simple curves, there is no need for complicated math. However, most functions in math are complicated and difficult to visualize. When I show this graph of function, I recall the mountains of the Karachay-Cherkess Republic, where my friends Eldar and Mariana had their wedding. In fact, I'm demonstrating an example of a piecewise monotonic function, that is, a graph which consists of a finite number of monotone intervals. Why do we pay so much attention to this type of functions? Unfortunately, human eye can perceive only such graphs, and human hand can draw only such graphs, no matter how hard you try. Of course, to be honest, we can't draw anything at all. If we see a curve, it means that it has non-zero thickness, which contradicts the rigorous mathematical definition of the graph of function. But it's not the point of our discussion. You can count how many monotone intervals our examples have. But there are tricky functions which have an infinite number of monotone intervals, or even not a single monotone interval. These examples will be the focus of our video. Let's begin with an interesting example, the Weierstrass function. You can describe this function only using a complicated formula, because only such level of complexity can show one of the major effects of this function. It hasn't got any intervals of monotonicity. That is, the graph of the function never increases, never decreases, and never plateaus. Just imagine that. Looking at the sketch of this graph, we might think that there is a finite number of increasing or decreasing intervals. Let's consider this blue fragment, which at first seems to be decreasing. It turns out that if we zoom in, we will see that the initial picture was not precise, and this supposedly decreasing fragment has a lot of other increasing and decreasing fragments, which violate the monotonicity. Let's take the purple fragment and zoom in on it too. We can see that again it's not a purely decreasing fragment. This process can be continued infinitely. We can grasp any seemingly monotonic fragment, zoom in on it, and see that it's not really monotonic. Our problem is that human brain cannot perceive infinite graphic effects, and our human eye only conveys information about a finite number of monotonic fragments, distorting reality. In such cases, we can analyze the graph of the function only using rigorous calculus, and we cannot rely on geometrical visualizations. This Weierstrass function hasn't got any monotone intervals, even though it's continuous. We can't even sketch its graph by hand, because the only thing we can draw is a piecewise monotonic curve. In my next video, we will take a look at functions with a large number of monotone intervals. In fact, an infinite number of such intervals. Mathematicians commonly call them saw-like functions.
Don't forget to press like or dislike button. If you don't want to miss my next video, please subscribe to my channel. And remember that all your comments are extremely appreciated.